Okay, hi everyone. Let's continue our discussion on the homework that I gave you last week. Okay, we stopped at question one, so today we continue with question two. Okay, question two, what is the duration in days? So the question asks you to give your answer in days. Bagi jawapan dalam hari, berapa hari? Thursday of the second week until Saturday of the third week. Okay, so second week, minggu kedua, Thursday, until the third week of Saturday. Minggu seterusnya, hari Sabtu. Now, we know that one week there are 7 days. So from second week of Thursday to third week of Wednesday, there are 7 days. Okay, we don't count from Thursday to Thursday. We count from Thursday until Wednesday. Okay, you can count starting from Thursday, right? Thursday is one day. Thursday, Friday, Saturday, Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday. So we only count until Wednesday. There are 7 days. So from Thursday, second week, until Wednesday, the following week, there are 7 days. Then from Wednesday until Saturday, from Thursday until Saturday, okay, we already counted until Wednesday, so we continue Thursday, Friday, Saturday. So how many days here? 1, 2, 3. 3 days here. So 7 days plus 3 days, the total is 10 days. Okay, remember, when you count 1 week, you don't count from Thursday to Thursday. You count from Thursday until Wednesday, one day earlier. So let's say you will start on Tuesday, then you count from Tuesday until Monday. Okay? So, Kamis awak kena kira juga. So, kita kira sampai Rabu saja. So, tak boleh kira Kamis hingga Kamis, satu minggu. Tidak. Ya, Kamis hingga Rabu, minggu seterusnya. Okay, question 2. 21 of May 2014 until 18 of June 2014. Okay, so 21 of May until 31st of May. We count May first, okay? Now, how many days do we have here? Do you take 31 minus 21 equals 10? Yes, you are right, but you need to plus 1 also, okay? 31 minus 21 is 10, and then you need to plus 1. Minus 10 and then plus 1, okay? That is how you do it. Because you need to calculate 21 also. So 21, you count until 31, there will be 11 days. Okay, 31 minus 21 is 10, and then plus 1 is 11 days. Then June, 1st of June until 18th of June. So this one is very simple. 1st until 18, there are 18 days. If you're not sure, you take 18 minus 1 is 17. 17, you need to plus 1 is 18. Okay, so formula dia awak ambil tarikh terakhir 31 Mei, tolak 21, awak dapat 10. Kemudian awak perlu tambah 1. Okay, perlu tambah 1 supaya hari yang pertama dikira juga. Yang Jun pun sama, 18, tolak 1 ialah 17. Lepas tu tambah balik 1, dia jadi 18. Okay, kemudian awak tambahkan, add up, you get 29 days. Okay, 29 days. Okay, 3A. State the duration in years, months, and days. Years, months, and days. So you have to give your answer in years, months, and days. Okay, A, April 2017 until August 2020. So from April 2017 until March 2020, this is 3 years. Okay, 2017 hingga 2018, 1 tahun. 2018 hingga 2019, 1 tahun. 2019 hingga 2020, 1 tahun. So jumlahnya 3 tahun. So from April until March. And then from April 2020 until August 2020, there are 5 months. Okay, you count from April, May, June, July, August. So 5 months. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So 5 months. So total we can give, total here is 3 years and 5 months. There are no days given here, so we only write the years and the month. There are no days here, no dates here. Okay, question B, there are days given. Okay, soalan B dia bagi hari bulan. So 23rd of February 2018 until 19 March 2023. Okay, let's change the color. So 23rd of February 2018 until one day earlier, satu hari awal, 22nd of February, dia mesti berakhir satu hari awal. 2023, here we have 5 years. Okay, 2018 until 2019, 1 year. 19 until 20, 2 years. 20 until 21, 3 years. 21 until 22, 4 years. 22 until 23, 5 years. Okay, 2018 hingga 2023, jumlah 5 tahun. Dan dia perlu berakhir satu hari awal daripada tarikh mulanya. So, 23rd until 22nd. And then, from, okay, here we stop at 22nd February. So, we continue 23rd February 2023 until 28th February, okay, in February there are 28 days for 2023. In the year 2023, there are only 28 days. Hanya 28 hari dalam February 2023. So how many days here? So same thing, you take 28 minus 23. 28 minus 23 is 5, and then you need to plus 1. Okay, tolak, lepas tu tambah 1. Kalau tidak, awak kira dari 23. 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28. So, 6 hari juga. So, kalau awak tolak, lepas tu tambah 1, awak dapat 6 hari juga. Okay, February selesai. Sekarang March. Kita kena jalan hingga 19 March ya. So, 1 hingga 19 March. Ini senang. 19 lah. Okay, 1 hingga 19 ialah 19 hari. So jumlah dia 5 tahun 25 hari. Okay, 5 years and 25 days. Okay, so this is the exercise for the homework that you did last week. Okay, let's continue with our lesson today. Okay, today we want to look at a new topic, World Time Zone. This is on page 98, buka surat 98. Okay, World Time Zone, apa tu? Iaitu waktu di seluruh dunia. Okay, seluruh dunia. Waktu dia berlainan. Okay, waktu di Malaysia sekarang pukul 10 pagi, tapi waktu di Amerika, di London, di Australia, dia semua lain waktu dia. Kenapa macam tu? Sebab dia, dunia ni dibahagi kepada 24 zon waktu. There are 24 time zones in this world. And the time begins at the Greenwich line in England. Okay, the time begins at the Greenwich line. Okay, if you look at this world map here, This is the Greenwich line. Can you see this line here? Ini Greenwich line nama dia. Mula dari dekat London ini. So masa ni bermula dekat line sini. Right? Greenwich line. So macam mana ni kita kira? For example, the time in Kuala Lumpur is 8 hours ahead. Lebih awal lah, ahead of the time in London. And then the time in Osaka is 1 hour ahead of the time in Kuala Lumpur. Okay, maksudnya waktu di Malaysia, KL, ialah 8 jam lebih awal daripada waktu di London. Bermaksud kalau London sekarang pukul 12. Okay, tengok ni, London pukul 12 tengah hari. Dekat KL sudah 8 pukul 8. 8 PM. Kita 8 jam lebih awal daripada London. Okay, our time here is 8 hours ahead. Ahead than London. Okay, London is 12 PM. Can you see this clock here? 12 PM London. London. Now in KL, now at the same time, we are already at 8 PM. We are already at 8 o'clock. Kita sudah berada di pukul 8 malam. Okay. Manakala Osaka. Osaka ni di Jepun. Jepun, dia pula 1 jam lebih awal daripada KL. 1 hour ahead of KL. So, kalau KL sekarang pukul 8, 8 PM, Osaka is already 9 PM. Sebab dia 1 jam lebih awal. So, dia sekarang sudah pukul 9 malam. KL baru pukul 8 malam. Kenapa begitu? Sebab dunia ni dia dibahagi kepada zon waktu. Dia ada zon waktu macam ni. Dia kan nampak baris-baris ni. Ni zon waktu dia. Okay. So kalau negara awak paling timur sekali, ni timur ah. Or in English east. If your country is to the east or to the as near as to the international deadline, your time is faster. Okay, negara yang berada di timur, waktu dia lebih awal. Jadi New Zealand, kita nampak ni, New Zealand dia paling awal. Also Australia, Jepun, lepas tu baru Malaysia. Okay, sebab itu bila kita meraihkan tahun baru, 1 Januari, negara New Zealand akan meraihkan dulu sebab mereka waktu mereka paling laju. So mereka akan sampai 1 Januari dulu. They will reach first of January first for New Zealand. They will celebrate New Year first. Then only Australia. Then baru Jepun. Then baru Malaysia. Then baru negara India. Dia gerak ke kiri, dia makin lambat. Dia gerak ke kiri barat, okay, west, dia gerak ke barat, dia lagi lambat. So London lagi lambat. So America paling lambat lah. Okay, so ingat, bila awak jawab soalan, awak akan kena tengok negara dia. Is it in the east? Okay, kalau negara dia dekat timur, east, maksudnya dia lebih awal. Kalau negara dia dekat barat atau west, waktu dia lebih lambat. Okay? Alright. So, saya rasa kita stop sini untuk hari ini saja. Kita akan sambung esok untuk topik ini. Okay, we'll continue tomorrow for this topic. Okay, I'll see you tomorrow. Goodbye!